In 1855, Walt Whitman self-published the first of 9 editions of Leaves of Grass. The majority of Whitman's audience came after he died, but it is still growing today. Whitman's words are so powerful that they linger in the reader's mind and connect with them on a more personal level. One of Whitman's most popular poems is Song of Myself. The first few lines are most memorable. He uses his technique or his way of connecting with the readers by being completely candid. By being open and honest, he lures his readers in and they feel close to him. Lines 1 through 3. I celebrate myself and sing myself. And what I assume, you shall assume. For every atom belonging to me, as good belongs to you. In his original preface, Whitman states, read these leaves in the open air every season of every year of your life. He says this to have his readers take his poems and reread them over and over again, experiencing new points of view through nature. After collecting opinions from my classmates, we have all agreed that Walt Whitman goes beyond the basic poet. He uses his words to sink into the reader's skin. A poem that stands out to me especially is Hear the Frailest Leaves of Me. Although it is brief, it is very powerful. Hear the Frailest Leaves of Me. Hear the frailest leaves of me, and yet my strongest lasting. Here I shade and hide my thoughts. I, myself, do not expose them. And yet, they expose me more than all my other poems. The openness and candor of Leaves of Grass is all suspected and assumed to have come from the art of opera. It is known that Walt Whitman enjoyed visiting the opera house as a young boy. Here's a small taste of what inspired the great Walt Whitman to produce his popular collection of poems, Leaves of Grass. Oh,